टुडे फ्रेंड्स वी विल डिस्कस अगेन वन इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन दैट कैन बी आस्क इन योर ब्लड बैंकिंग स्पेशली एंड इन योर जॉब इंटरव्यूज ऑल्सो दैट विच एंटीकॉगुलेंट यूज इन ब्लड कलेक्शन दैट टाइम योर आंसर इज दैट एंटीकॉगुलेंट यूज इन ब्लड कलेक्शन इज CPDA एंड वट इज़ द एब्रीवेशन ऑफ CPDA सी स्टैंड फॉर साइट्रेट P for phosphate, D for dextrose and A for adenine. And mostly blood collection bags, they will contain 63 ml CPDA anticoagulant. If we have to collect the blood, 450 ml. This quantity of anticoagulant, 63 ml, is enough to ensure that the function of blood cells will be stable. And when we will collect the blood, after collection, the storage temperature is 2 to 8 degree centigrade. And the duration of storage will be 28 to 35 days. And before using these blood collection packs, this should be stored at below 28 degree centigrade, means at room temperature. But it should be care that it will be out of direct sunlight. And these bags have mostly shelf life of 2 years or 3 years. This expiry date is mentioned on the foil envelope, mostly Baxter Fenwill blood bags used. And the label on blood bag will show the expiry date. So we can know that until how much time we can use these blood bags. So the main thing in this lecture is that which anticoagulant used in blood collection. So your answer is CPDA, citrate, phosphate, dextrose, adenine. And if we are going to collect 450 ml blood, then the quantity of anticoagulant will be 63 ml. And just for knowledge, you remember that if we are going to collect 350 ml blood, then the anticoagulant will be 49 ml. That I forget to mention here. And when we will collect the blood after collection, this bag with blood, we can store at 28 to 35 days. We can store for 28 to 35 days at 2 to 8 degree centigrade. And it will be noticed that when we will collect the blood after collection, the storage temperature, duration, these play very important role to keep the cells in their proper condition. Otherwise, transfusion reactions can occur. Otherwise, these cells will not be able to transport oxygen or to remove carbon dioxide from the body in the recipient. So this was for the knowledge, but main thing you have to remember the name of anticoagulant we will use in blood collection. So this lecture is going to complete here. I will meet you with new lecture, new information as soon as possible. Until that, thank you so much for your support and keep supporting me. Thank you so much. Take care of yourselves.